students, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. I am very happy to see you again. In this video, we are going to discuss a new topic that is called thyroid gland. This thyroid gland is interesting topic also, because this gland is highly essential for various growth of body. So what is the significance of thyroid gland? Where it was located, what is the size, what is the structure, what is the function? These are the things we are going to discuss in this topic. So first we will see thyroid gland. It is an endocrine gland. This gland, otherwise we can say butterfly gland. It seems to be H-shaped. So where it is located? This is the trachea. So see the trachea, here is the side of trachea. Below the larynx, here the larynx is there. So below the larynx, here is the side of trachea. There are two lobes are there. These two lobes are called thyroid gland. But these two lobes are connected by tissues, immediate tissues, that is called isthmus. So we are going in detail. So now see that this butterfly gland or H-shaped gland, where it was located, location below the larynx and either side of trachea, either side of trachea. So this is the largest endocrine gland. Largest endocrine gland. When compared to other glands, it is the largest endocrine glands. And one more thing, this endocrine gland, the color is brownish red color. Brownish red color. This gland is two lobes of it. It has two lobes. These two lobes are connected by a medial tissue. This is called isthmus. So we will see the details. So just imagine. So here the trachea is there. In trachea, two lobes are there. Two lobes. It looks like a butterfly shape. So it's called butterfly gland. We can say that this butterfly gland located below the larynx and either side of trachea. It is the largest endocrine gland, brownish in reddish color. Two lobes are there. Two lobes are connected by isthmus. And one more thing, it is highly vascular. So in this thyroid gland, in Greek, we can see that thyroid means in Greek letter, it is called shield. Iod means shape. So in Greek, thyroid means shield, iod means shape. So you can shield shape diagram. Now I will draw a diagram of thyroid gland, a simple way to understand. So now I already told that two lobes are there. So these two lobes like this. Like this, two lobes are there. Either side of trachea, here trachea is there. Like this, trachea is there. Either side of trachea, two lobes are there. These two lobes, this is called one lobe. And this is called one lobe. So it is called bilobed gland. These two lobes are connected by immediate tissues. this part, it connects the two lobes, the median tissue. This is called isthmus. This is called isthmus. So, inside the lobes, several lobules are present. Inside the lobules, what happens? One more structure is present, that is called follicles. So like this. Some follicle cells are. Like this, several follicle cells are present in the lobules. So like this. So inside the lobe, so two lobes are there. Inside the lobes, lobules are present. Inside the lobules, follicle cells are present. Totally, the follicle cells. So we can say like this. So lobes has lobules. Inside the lobules, follicle cells are there. Follicle cells. This is the black structure over there. This is called follicle cells. This is called follicle cells. This is the follicle cells. So now it's called follicle cells. So inside the follicle cells, so there is a cavity. It's a lumen is there. This like lumen. This lumen is there. This lumen contains a special fluid. So inside the follicle cells, it contains a special fluid. It is called colloid, a fluid. So these follicle cells, for example, see this is follicle cells. These follicle cells are lined with a special type of cells that is called cuboidal epithelial cells. This is a follicle cells. So now it's a follicle cell. I'm realizing this. So what happens? So this is follicle cells. These follicle cells are aligned with some special cells like this. So these follicle cells are aligned with some special cells like this. So these cells are called cuboidal. Cuboidal epithelial, cuboidal squamous epithelial cells, cuboidal epithelial cells. So once again, I repeat it. So thyroid gland has two lobes. This lobe contains several lobules. Inside the lobules, several follicle cells are present. The follicle cells, approximately 3 million follicles. 3 million follicle cells are there in the thyroid gland. So inside the these follicle cells are aligned with their cuboidal squamous epithelial cells. This arrangement is more essential for the synthesis of thyroxine. We will discuss in later. So this contains cuboidal cells. And this again, acinar cells. Acinar cells. So inside this lumen, this is lumen. This is lumen. This cavity inside the follicle cells, fluid is there. This fluid is called colloid fluid. So now it is called colloid fluid. Inside the colloid fluid, one more substance is there. That is called thyroglobulin is a glycoprotein. So this thyroglobulin, nothing but it's a compound of tyrosine, amino acid. It's a combination of tyrosine and amino acids. So once again, I'll explain. So two ropes are there. Inside the lobes, several lobules are there. inside the cells, follicle cells are there, these black structures. The follicle cells, maybe 3 million follicle cells are there. So each follicle cells, I am giving a big shape here. These follicle cells covered by pubertal epithelial cells. Others are acinar cells. This is called acinar cells. So inside the follicle cells, there is a cavity. So lumen is there. This lumen is filled with colloid fluid. This fluid contains nothing but the substance called thyroglobulin. Thyroglobulin, nothing but it is a glycoprotein. It's a glycoprotein. It contains what? Tyrosine. It contains a tyrosine. So with help of tyrosine, thyroxine is synthesized. Listen here, students. So this is follicle cells. Apart from follicle cells, outside the follicle cells, some special cells are there. Some other cells also present. So like this. Here also. So outside the follicle cells, so like this, the blue color structures. These cells are called para follicular cells. This is called para follicular cells. So one more name is there are C cells. This is called C cells. So thyroid is a peculiar gland because this thyroid gland secretes hormones. So some hormones are made up of peptide, some hormones are made up of modified amino acids. Whereas from follicle cells, especially the acinar cells, these cells secretes the help of tyrosine, these cells secretes thyroxine. So follicle cells secretes thyroxine. This thyroxine is a modified amino acid hormone. Whereas the C cell, this C cell secretes a special hormone, so thyrocalcitonin. So thyrocalcitonin, one more hormone. Already I told that thyroxine. This thyroxine it has two forms. One is called T3, one is called T4. This T4 is called thyroxine, whereas T3 triiodothyronine, whereas T4 tetraiodothyronine. So this tetraiodothyronine is called thyroxine, whereas T3 is called triiodothyronine. These two hormones synthesized from the follicle cells, especially the acinar cells. Whereas apart from follicle cells, some cells are there outside the follicles. So see that the blue color structures, these cells are called para follicular cells, otherwise you can say C cells. This C cell secretes a hormone is called thyrocalcitonin. This thyrocalcitonin helps to reduce the calcium level in blood. So it reduces the calcium level in blood. So it helps to reduce the calcium level in blood. So it is called hypocalcemic hormone. Is that right? Hypocalcemic hormone. So once again I repeat all these things. So a thyroid gland is called butterfly gland. It is located below the larynx and either side of trachea. It has two lobes, so it is called bilobed gland. It is highly vascular, brownish, reddish color glands. Two lobes are there. Inside the lobes, the lobules are present. Inside the lobules, the follicle cells are present, which is the black color structures. These follicle cells lined with pubertal squamous epithelial cells. Inside this structure, a lumen is there. There is a cavity is there. This cavity contains a colloid fluid. This colloid fluid contains a thyroglobulin. Thyroglobulin, nothing but a glycoprotein. This glycoprotein contains a tyrosine. It is an amino acid. This tyrosine helps in the synthesis of thyroxine. Thyroxine has two forms. One is T3 and T4. T3 is called triiodothyronine And T4 is called tetraiodothyronine. This is exactly you can say thyroxine hormone. These two hormones from follicular cells. And apart from follicular cells, some other structures are there, blue color structures. It is called parafollicular cells, are called C cells. These C cells secrete the hormones called thyrocalcitonin. This thyrocalcitonin helps to reduce the calcium level in the blood. So it is called hypocalcemic hormone. So thyroid secretes thyroxine. Thyroid secretes thyroxine. So for synthesis of thyroxine, iodine is essential or more important. So thyroxine, you can say it is a iodinated hormone. It is a iodinated hormone. Probably 65% of iodine is present in thyroxine. So once again, thyroxine nothing but it is a hormone, the thyroid gland. This thyroxine nothing but iodine is essential for the synthesis. So most important significant component. So this iodine present 60% so this is what? Iodinated hormone. This thyroxine synthesizes inside the thyroid gland. So I want to tell you that it is called cuboidal squamous epithelium cells. This cuboidal squamous epithelium cell, which is present in the lining of follicle cell, it has two functions. It has two functions. One function is this cuboidal squamous cells. So this is, for example, this is blood. Just remember, this is blood. So from the blood, iodine is present. So iodine is present. So these iodine particles are trapped by cuboidal squamous epithelial cells to inside the lumen of follicle cell, so that thyroxine synthesis takes place. So this is iodine. The iodine particle which is present in the blood is was trapped by to inside the follicle cells, inside the collagen structure, inside the lumen. So this iodine will get inside the lumen only because of this cuboidal squamous epithelial cell. So it is the first function is it to trap iodine molecules. So this is the first function, it trap iodine molecules. The second function is it helps to secrete thyroglobulin. So these are the two important function of cuboidal epithelial squamous epithelial cells. It's the most important information for the examination point of view. So these two functions by cuboidal squamous epithelial cells, it has a feedback mechanisms. So how the synthesis takes place, how the thyroxine hormone is synthesized inside the cell, inside the thyroid gland, you see that first hypothalamus. This hypothalamus secretes some hormones which stimulate, it secretes some hormones, it is called thyroid releasing hormone. So hypothalamus first secretes thyroid releasing hormone. This thyroid releasing hormone will stimulate the adenohypophysis to secrete TSH. This is called thyroid stimulating hormone. This thyroid stimulating hormone from adenohypophysis, so from adenohypophysis, this hormone will stimulate the thyroid gland. To secrete thyroxine. So this is the process. So first hypothalamus releases a hormone. That is called thyroid releasing hormone. This thyroid releasing hormone stimulates the adenohypophysis. It is the anterior part of pituitary. So this adenohypophysis secretes TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone. This thyroid stimulating hormone stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete thyroxine. This is the process how it takes the synthesis of thyroxine.
So far we have discussed the structure, location, function and the significance of the thyroid gland. Now we will discuss the functions of thyroxine. So this thyroxine is a hormone secreted by thyroid gland, especially T3 and T4. T3 is called triiodothyronine, T4 is called tetraiodothyronine, especially called thyroxine. This thyroxine is more important to maintain BMR, that is called basal metabolic rate. It produces body heat. It is essential for various physical activities of the body. So the second function is, it is highly essential for mental development. So especially the growth of skeletal system and also nervous system. So one more function is there, it is essential, helps for protein synthesis in the body. And not only protein synthesis, so normal gonadal function also enhanced by this hormone. This thyroxine is very important for normal gonadal function, especially testes and the ovaries. And also it reduces the serum cholesterol level in the blood. It helps to reduce the cholesterol in the blood. And one more important function, it regulates the blood pressure. So many functions are there. Out of this, the most important function, maintenance of basal metabolic rate. It helps in growth of nervous system, circulatory system, and also mental development. Helps in protein synthesis. Helps in normal gonadal functions. It reduces the serum cholesterol level. It regulates the blood pressure. These are the important function of thyroxine. Next hormone, that is called TCT, that is called thyrocalcitonin. So this thyrocalcitonin secreted by a synthesis by C cells or para follicular cells. This thyrocalcitonin is a peptide hormone. Whereas the T3 and T4, these hormones secrete the thyroid gland, but they are called modified amino acids. Whereas the same thyroid gland secretes one more type of hormone, called peptide hormone. This peptide hormone helps to reduce the calcium and phosphate in blood. So it reduces the calcium level and phosphate in the blood. So it is called hypocalcemic hormone. So it is hypocalcemic hormone. So TCT secreted by C cells or parafollicular cells. This is a peptide hormone. The most function is, important function is, it reduces the calcium and phosphate level in the blood. So it is called hypocalcemic hormone. Dear students, thank you for watching this video. I made it clear about this structure of thyroid gland and its location, function, size, shape and their hormones, everything. I made it clear to you, I think. If you like this video, you subscribe this video and share this video to your friends and support me. And any doubts if you have, means you can come on my inbox, give your questions. I try to answer for your questions. Thank you.